Welcome to UGC e-Pathshala lecture series in computer science. This is cloud computing and we are discussing election in cloud mod part 3. So, the learning objectives of this module is the analysis of ring algorithm. We will look at cloud and the relation of election algorithms with cloud, and we will see some of the practical examples where election has been or are being used in cloud computing, followed by the summary. So, in the last class, we looked at the ring algorithm. We started with what is the logical ring, and we looked at the election algorithm, which is the ring algorithm. In this class, we will look at the analysis of the ring algorithm and the necessity of cloud and election in practice. So, to be able to do analysis of any distributed algorithm, we look at two things. One is what is the best case, and in this particular place, the best case comes in terms of the number of messages that have to be passed. It's a very important criteria in a distributed environment to see how many messages it is required by the algorithm to pass to be able to complete the algorithm. So, best case comes when the, we are using the least number of algorithms. So, therefore, obviously, the worst case will be when there are the largest number of communication messages must be exchanged. So, the algorithm itself should not require so many messages is what we need to look at. So, when we look at the ring algorithm, when will the best case come? The best case comes when the highest process initiates the election. So, let us look at an example where the best case can occur. In this example, we are seeing that there are 6 nodes and P95 is the highest node. If crash of the leader node is identified by P95, then it will be the initiator and it will start with the election, P95. So, election, P95 is the first message. Then P20 will forward the message, P1 will forward that message, and so on, and finally it will reach P95. When it reaches back P95, P95 understands that I am the leader, and then P95 has to send a coordinator message. Again, coordinator message will be forwarded by all the nodes till it has reached the coordinator back. So, n number of messages, if there are total number of n processes, in our case there were 6 processes. So, election, P95 starting from the initiator came back to the initiator, and initiator decided that it is the coordinator, that is 6 messages, and then initiator has to inform everybody. So, initiator sends coordinator message to the next node, and that roams around and comes back to the initiator, the coordinator, that is another 6 messages. So, therefore, n election message and n coordinator message. So, together there is a total of 2 of n messages. So, if there are say 100 nodes in our ring, then 200 messages will ensure to elect the coordinator, provided the initiator itself is the ultimately coordinator. That means the highest node, highest priority, highest number, whatever our criteria is, based on that criteria, which node, that particular node should start the election process, right? That is our best case. Now, what is the worst case scenario in electing in ring based election algorithm? The worst case is when the node next to the highest node realizes that the leader has failed. In this case, if P100 was the leader and it has crashed, and P20 becomes the initiator, that is P95 will be the next coordinator, and P20 understands that current coordinator P100 has failed and an election algorithm has to be started. Then what will happen? It will send a message election, P20. P1 will let it go, P20. P50 will change it to election, P50. P80 will change it to election, P80. P30 will pass it as election, P80 till it has not reached the actual highest node. Therefore, we have spent n minus 1 messages already. Then now P95 will send election, P95. Remember, our algorithm says that the message of election, PK has to come back to PK. So, therefore, now only election, P95 will go, do the whole round and will come back. So, another n messages for this specific message to go and come back. And now that P95 knows that it is the coordinator, it has to send a coordinator message to all the nodes, and that message will pass around and will come back. So, another n messages. So, to get the total number of messages, n minus 1, the first initiator process has to send, that reaches, because in the worst case, the initiator is just one node after the highest node. It will be n minus 1 by the time it comes back to the possible future coordinator. Then when the coordinator starts sending election, P95 or election, PK, another n messages for that message to come back to the node PK, and coordinator message will be sent and will be come back. So, therefore, a total of 3n minus 1 messages have to be exchanged in the worst case scenario. So, n number of messages. So, therefore, these are algorithms, is a linear requirement, but if I, instead of 100 nodes, if I have say 1000 nodes, then the number of messages will increase by approximately 1000 more messages. Why we are worried about the number of messages is because network does not work that well if it is congested. And we do not want algorithms to send unnecessarily greater number of messages and crowd the network, which may have already been crowded. If we can save even some messages from being sent, it is always a good idea. So, therefore, our analysis of any algorithm is done based on the on its ability to send and receive the number of messages that it is going to be using. Next problem with the ring algorithm is, as we discussed in the last class, that what will happen if there is there are multiple initiators. So, in this example, we are saying P20 is an initiator and P80 is also an initiator. P20 will send messages P20 to everybody. It will be received by P95, and then P95 will send election, P95. It will do its round and come back. On the other hand, in the same example, that means in the same ring, P80 also understood that the coordinator has crashed, and P80 has sent messages. P80's message has been changed by P95 here, and P95's message has been has done the rounds and come back. So, if P20 is the initiator, then there will be n minus 1 plus n. If P80 is the initiator, then this is 2 messages plus n messages, n plus 2 messages will be gone. But after all these messages by both the initiators, what will happen? P95 will decide that I am the coordinator in both the cases. So, For P20 also P95 will be the coordinator. For P80 initiated election algorithm also P95 will be the coordinator, and in both the cases P95 will become the final coordinator. So therefore, multiple initiators, there should not be a problem. If we do nothing about multiple initiators, if we do not take care of multiple initiators at all, if we just allow any node that detects that there is a problem in the system and the coordinator is not responding, they independently starts these algorithms, there should not be any problem at all. Both algorithms will go and they will both elect the next highest node in the system. But if you look at the number of messages, quite unnecessarily we are allowing so many messages to be passed around. Now, what is a solution for this? Can we first of all understand that both two initiators are trying to elect leader for the same purpose? Unfortunately, in a distributed environment, the purpose is not mentioned. It is very difficult to add the purpose of leader election into the election process. So therefore, it is not recognizable by the nodes that are using the participating in the election algorithm to understand that this is the same node selection. So therefore, we cannot do it at that level. But where can we do? This is what we will do. We will include the initiator's ID with all the messages. And we say that if I receive two election messages in that ring, and if I have already received a message and I am receiving another message to elect another leader, then what we will do is we will compare the IDs of the initiators. And after comparing the ID of the initiator, I will forward a node, a participating node who has received the, who is receiving the election message the second time, will only forward that specific message where the initiator is having the higher ID. So therefore, if P80 and P20 both try to elect specific coordinator, then only P80s will request will go through and P20s will be stopped by the participating, by one of the participating nodes. Therefore, the election started by the highest initiator will be completed and values will be given. Now, what is the election that is required in a cloud environment? In reality, many existing cloud environment uses or are using election algorithms. As we have been discussing, that cloud consists of many data centers, and these data centers have multiple servers, and they almost always they do quite similar work. So therefore, some form of election to decide the leader among these peers are required. For example, Apache Zookeeper is a service given where it has an inbuilt election mechanism that we are going to look at. Google Stubby is another system. It is a log service, but it has a mechanism to elect a primary node. So let us first look at the Zookeeper. Zookeeper is a coordination service which is used by many open source cloud platforms. For example, HBase uses it, Rackspace uses it, IBM uses Zookeeper. So many other open source tools also uses, platforms also uses Zookeeper. What Zookeeper does is they have for every communication, they have a flag. They set this flag, and these flags are of two types. One is called a sequence flag and another is called an ephemeral flag. They use these flags to perform election. whenever a user expresses the requirement that they need to elect one specific node for a specific purpose, it uses these flags to use to do the election. What they have is called Z nodes, which are the data registers, and these Z nodes create a path using which the election can take place. The sequence of flag in each Z node is this unique sequence number. As we have already seen, that using unique numbers, we can easily implement an election algorithm. What BookKeeper uses is quite similar to Boolean algorithm, and it elects a specific one, specific Z node, having whatever criteria that we are selecting. So, they send messages through a set of Z nodes according to the requirement of the user, and through this, using a Boolean-like algorithm, that specific Z node is elected, which is going to be the leader. Next, we look at Google's Chubby, this tool by Google. This is used essentially for log service. So, if we need to log a system, typically what is used is called Google's Chubby tool. For any loosely coupled distributed system, Chubby is a very good tool, and therefore, of course, cloud comes as the best place to use the cloud, the Google's Chubby algorithm. Multiple Google's platform, in fact, there are publications where we see that many of large number of Google's platforms use the Google's Chubby and its existing locking mechanism and election mechanism for electing a primary. For example, Bigtable uses it, GFS file service, Google's file service uses it. It has a mechanism called a Megastore, it uses it, and so on. So, what is the Chubby, Google Chubby, what does it do? It consists of a number of servers. Now, these servers are not independent servers, but they are all replicated servers. So, a set of servers which are replicated, which means that each of these servers are identical with each other, and it is required therefore that they need a leader who will have the controlling power. So, since this is a set, and together they have to either put a lock or get release a lock. So, therefore, one of the nodes should have the controlling power to control the overall system. So, therefore, election is a necessity in such a system. So, among so many, what is the election protocol that Google's Chubby uses? First, decides among all the replicated nodes, some specific set of smaller subset of nodes that are the potential leaders. So, the election is not thrown open to all, one small subset of the nodes will be up for running the election, and then these potential nodes or that possible leaders will ask for votes. They will try vie for getting more votes for their account. All the participating servers that are there in that one cluster will vote for one leader or the other. The restriction being that only one leader they can vote for. So, every server will vote for one or the other. Whichever node is having the maximum number of votes will become the new leader. So, among these servers A, B, C, D, E, if D is a potential leader and it has asked for vote, and if it gets the maximum number of votes, then it becomes the new master, and this new master will declare itself that I am the leader. The elected leader may fail. Every system wherever there is a leader not only requires to elect a leader, but also needs to specify that in case the current leader has failed, what is the mechanism of identifying that the leader has failed, and what is the mechanism of ensuring that a new leader is elected. So, Google Stubby uses a very interesting mechanism, which it says to be a lease. It is called a master lease. So, even when a leader is elected, it is not going to remain as a leader forever. It has to have a lease, and typically these leases are given for a few seconds. So, maximum that has been observed in the usage of Google Stubby is that the master lease has been given for 30 seconds. That is the maximum. Typically, it will be a few seconds which will be given for the master node to remain as the master. End of that, the master node does not by default continues to be the master. So, what happens when the lease expires? The master node has to renew. The renewal process will be quite the same as the election process, which means that it will again ask for votes. And at that point in time, when the lease expires, even other nodes can become the potential leader, and they can ask for votes. And in a similar manner, will be voting election will be conducted, and it will be decided which node becomes the master node. So, the old master can continue to become the new leader, or a new leader can be elected. In case a master fails before the lease expires, and this is where Google perhaps goes away from our typical distributed convention, they do not elect another election. Only when the lease expires, new leader will be elected. So, in between this time, no leader or no master will be there in that specific set, and whatever Google does will be have to do without the master. Now, if we want to look at the correctness of this particular mechanism, it is expected that Google has a very large number of nodes in their environment, and conducting election every now and then causes more number of communication to be executed among the nodes, and therefore it is not really required or desirable. So, what is the practical difficulty that we can face when there is no elected node in the environment? Actually, the leader is not required all the time. So, only very specific few work is needed for the leader to be there, and when the leader is not available, always those work will be withheld, but other things will continue. Rather than congesting the network unnecessarily, Google has the Google Stubby has the decision that we are better off if we do not congest the network unnecessarily. In summary of all the three election modules, we looked at the requirement of election in a distributed environment, and specifically in the presence or in a cloud. Even in a distributed environment, we will see, or we have already seen to some extent, that there are many nodes which are similar in capabilities. We replicate our nodes, and we for backup purpose, for better availability, for many different reasons, we replicate our nodes and create multiple nodes which are quite similar to each other. And coordination among these nodes may be difficult and or may not be possible without knowing one of the nodes. A typical example of where election is required in a distributed environment may be given by a distributed transaction example. In a distributed transaction, what happens is that a transaction is divided into smaller parts, and each part is given to one of the nodes to execute. But transaction has the ACID property, which means that once a transaction is completed, it should be completed fully or it should be totally aborted. If it is done in a distributed fashion, then what happens is it has to execute only either all or none basis. And among all these peers, one node has to coordinate to ensure that the transaction has followed the ACID property. Distributed transaction is a typical one where among all these peers, one of the nodes has to work like a coordinator or a leader and has to maintain the ACID property or that all or none property. Similarly, there are many work which requires us to execute in a cloud also. The leadership requirement is there. We looked at two classical election protocols. One is called the Boolean algorithm. In Boolean algorithm, the highest node, as the name suggests, the highest node bullies its way through and becomes the leader. There nobody elects a leader, it selects itself. And the justification of having such an algorithm is that we can use some specific criteria again to decide, and no need for others to just to decide the leader, only the leader itself can take a decision. The other algorithm we looked at is called the ring based election algorithm. In ring based election algorithm, on the other hand, every node helps in electing the current leader. If a node is receiving a election message, then it has to take a look at whether it wants to, it has the capability of becoming the leader, or if it does not have the capability of becoming the leader, it simply forwards the election message to the next node. And then we looked at election in cloud, where we feel that a cloud being large number of data centers and having similar servers and many replicated services, it is important to have the cloud to be having an election. And in cloud election, we looked at Apache Zookeeper, which uses a Boolean-like algorithm, where they have the Z nodes and these nodes help them rather elect one of the Z nodes to be the leader. It is not a default mechanism in the sense that not always Zookeeper will have a election going. Only when a user requires an election among certain peer nodes, the Z nodes will create a sequence of paths and unique sequence of paths, and it will execute the election. Next, we looked at Google Chubby, where which is basically a locking mechanism used by many Google's mechanisms, and we saw that it uses a typical voting system, which is not one of the classical algorithms, but it takes votes from all the participating nodes and it looks at the one that gets the highest vote becomes the current leader. So, in the next class, we will look at the other mechanism of distributed systems, which is the mutual exclusion. These are the references. Thank you.